Tag memory is an important part of JS Engine's memory architecture. During our code's execution, tag is the first region of memory that is used to access all the variable data, even in heap, which is accessed through references in the stack. Hi, I am Rohan, and this video is part of a series of videos where we are exploring how JS is managing its memory. So let's get to it. What exactly is stack memory? Stack memory is a continuous segment of memory that is used to store static data. Now, what do I mean by static data? Static data includes primitive values such as strings or numbers, etc., or references to objects and functions. Unlike dynamic data, whose size might expand or shrink during runtime, the static data has a fixed size that is known by the JS engine during compilation. As a result, the engine allocates a predetermined amount of memory to each of these values just before the execution, and after it has executed, it deallocates the memory. This allocation is known as static memory allocation. The data that is stored in the stack is in a linear format, so it is easier and faster to access this data. And since JavaScript is a single-threaded language, it can only utilize one stack. Now, why is stack memory used? Why even bother? There are certain important advantages of using stack memory instead of, say, just using a heap. First of all, it is much faster than the heap. The allocation of stack memory is linear and the engine knows exactly where to find all the data. It doesn't have to search for it, so it can access each of the data very quickly. Secondly, the size of the memory that will be needed is already known at the compile time, and a predetermined amount of memory is allocated before execution and then deallocated. This leads to a predictable and optimized memory usage, which also means that the allocation and deallocation of memory in the stack is pretty straightforward. When a function is called, then its variables, the primitive values and the object references are allocated memory in the stack. And when the function is done executing, then the variable memories are deallocated. Mostly, I will talk about this and closures in a moment. Let's look at a couple of examples to visualize how stack memory works. In this first example, we calculate the kinetic energy of a car of a certain mass moving at a certain velocity. When we execute the script, a stack frame is pushed into the stack memory. This frame has all the outer variables declared and initialized with undefined, along with a reference to the function that is added to the memory heap. Then the two variables are assigned, which updates the stack memory, and the function is called using them. As soon as the function is called, a corresponding stack frame is pushed into the stack memory containing the two parameters and the local variables. The two parameters, mass and velocity, are initialized with the values, and the variables are initialized with undefined. After that, each line is executed and the calculated values are assigned to the variables, which updates it in the stack memory. Then the calculated energy is returned, the stack frame is popped, and the memory is released. The returned value from the function is assigned to kinetic energy in J, and the stack is updated. Finally, the execution completes and the stack and heap memory is released. In the second example, we calculate simple interest but with a twist. There are three nested functions, setInterest, depositAmount and calcSimpleInterest, each returning another function. But the last one is returning the calculated simple interest value. When we execute the script, a stack frame is pushed into the stack memory with variables set to undefined and a reference to setInterest, which is added to the heap. Now, setInterest is called with 12. So a corresponding stack frame is pushed into the stack memory and interest is initialized with 12. In the return statement, a function depositAmount is declared, so it is added to the heap and its corresponding reference is added to the function's return value in the stack memory. After that, the function returns depositAmount. Now, according to what we have discussed so far, the stack memory should be released. But if that happens, the inner functions won't be able to utilize the outer function's local variables. In our case, interest. So, in situations like this, a snapshot is taken of all the local variables. This includes variables with object references and stored in an object in the memory heap. This is called closure. So the stack frame is popped from the memory and the memory is released. But the closure persists in the memory heap till we are done executing all the inner functions. Now, the outer deposit amount variable is assigned with the returned function reference, which updates the stack memory. And in the next line, this function is called with 47,500. This pushes a stack frame into the stack memory with principal set to 47,500 and a reference to the closure of set interest. The function returns calc simple interest immediately. So calc simple interest is added to the heap and its corresponding reference is returned. And a closure of deposit amount is created with principal and added to the heap also. The stack frame is popped and the memory is released. The returned function reference is assigned to the outer variable calc simple interest, which is updated in the corresponding stack memory. This is called in the next line with 10. So a frame is pushed into the stack memory with time set to 10 and references to the closures of deposit amount and set interest, which contains principal and interest respectively. These values are multiplied and then divided by 100. The resultant value is assigned to the return value in the stack. This value is returned and the frame is popped out of the stack and the memory is released. The return value is assigned to the outer variable simple interest, which is updated in the corresponding stack memory. This finishes the execution. So the script frame is popped out of the stack and the stack and heap memory is released. Notice that the memory occupied by the closures keep on persisting in the heap till the script is finished with its execution. What this means is that till there are references to the inner functions, deposit amount and calc simple interest in the stack memory, the closures of the outer functions set interest and deposit amount will keep on persisting in the heap memory. So be careful with closures. They have a potential to create memory leaks. So what are the key takeaways from our discussion so far? When a script is executed, then a script or a global frame is pushed into the stack memory, and for every function call, a dedicated frame is pushed into the stack memory. When the function call is complete, then that frame is popped out of the stack. When the script is finished executing, then the last frame is also popped out of the stack. Each stack frame in the memory stack is responsible for storing local variable data and references to outer function closures. These can be primitive values or object references. In case of nested functions, if there is a reference to an inner function in the stack memory, then the corresponding references to the closures of the outer functions persists in the memory heap. The stack memory cannot operate without the heap memory. So we will discuss this next. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Namaskar.